Can red light therapy improve oral health, reduce pain and inflammation? It's John from the Biohack Channel, and today I'll be taking a look at red light therapy devices for oral health. I want to mention that this video will focus on technology for general wellness. I am not a medical professional. The information shared here is based on my personal experience and is for educational purposes only. If you're on Facebook, check out our Red Light Therapy group with over 14,000 members. I vet and review products and provide a detailed breakdown with discount codes to save you money at checkout. Okay, so let's get back to the video. My original post using oral care red light therapy devices dates back over 4 years. My interest stems from the widespread belief that oral health is linked to whole body health. Like most people, I started out looking at devices with red and near-infrared LEDs embedded in a dental tray-style design and sealed in silicone. After about 1 year, I followed up with another post, highlighting the performance scores using three different tray-style oral care devices. While some of these devices had enough power density to be noticeably effective, I ran into a short list of problems that led me to search for something better. I still think this tray style can be improved over time, so if anything new comes on the market, I'll update with another video or write-up. The biggest drawbacks from all three brands summed up on this list. Fast forward to spring of this year, I started looking at LED torches that come with a fiber optic probe attachment. Now these have their own set of problems, but don't suffer from the main drawbacks of the dental tray style devices. Mainly, the torch design allows for better targeting with high power density and easy cleaning as the probe is just a piece of glass inside a metal tube. Most LED torches can deliver about 4 joules per spot in 15 to 20 seconds. LED torches come in several different sizes and styles. LED torches don't come without drawbacks. For example, the edges of the probes are sharp and heat can quickly build up in the beamer assembly. The higher the chip count means you'll receive a wider range of wavelengths within the beam. On average, high chip count can also build up more heat. I'll explain a hack for this later in the video. So what's the main drawback to LED torches? Well, some models can be expensive, and I found no real advantage to expensive models over the lower cost ones. They all have the same high drain circuit and battery type and suffer from heat buildup. Here's a beam size comparison between a fiber optic probe and a small flat pen torch. Let's take a quick look at the lithium ion batteries. These come in many different styles. If possible, try to avoid the smaller twin batteries with button tops. These tend to drain unevenly and fail at higher rates. If you end up owning several of these torches, I recommend using a universal IntelliCharger that accepts multiple size batteries and smart charging. It's better to buy multiple torches and rotate through them as the heat builds up. As the batteries drain, the power density can drop as well, so having multiple torches can help solve these problems. I think that's a wrap for this video. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe for the YouTube algorithm. If you're on Facebook, check out our group with over 14,000 members. It's a great way to share your self-improvement journey and learn valuable insights from the community.